Have you ever wondered how computers send data on the network without interfering with the data from other computers? Especially if the network has a lot of computers that are sending and receiving data at the same time. I mean, you would think that there would be a lot of collisions happening. I mean, there should be data packets that are constantly smacking into each other in all that network traffic. But even though collisions do happen from time to time, especially on older networks, a technology was developed to not only help avoid collisions, but also to respond correctly if a collision does happen. And this technology is called CSMA-CD, which stands for Carrier Sense Multiple Access Collision Detection. And this is the access method used on early Ethernet networks. And when I mean early, I'm referring to half-duplex networks that utilized coaxial cable and earlier versions of twisted pair cable. Now, CSMA-CD basically works by each computer first sensing if the wire is idle. And if it is, it sends its data, therefore avoiding any collisions. But if you have two computers trying to send data at the same time, a collision will happen. And if a collision happens, the computers will wait a random amount of time and retries to send their data. So as an example, here we have a network with four computers, and these computers are all sharing a common transmission medium, which is a cable. And this cable must be regulated so that no computers send data at the same time, which would result in a collision. And when a collision happens, it causes data loss or data corruption. So let's say that this computer here wants to send data. So first, it will sense or listen if there is any traffic on the cable. And if it senses traffic, the computer will wait until the cable is idle to send its data. But once it senses that there is no traffic, it'll go ahead and send its data. And as it's sending its data, it will listen for a collision. And if it doesn't sense a collision, it knows that the data was successfully sent. Now, in another scenario, if two computers are ready to send their data, and they both notice that the cable is idle, then both computers will go ahead and transmit their data at the same time. But when this happens, a collision occurs. And when the computers that are sending the data detect a collision, they immediately stop sending the data and instead will transmit a jamming signal out on the network. And this jamming signal is what notifies all the other computers on the network that a collision has happened. And after the computers receive this jamming signal, the two computers that caused the collision will wait a random amount of time before they send their data again. And the wait time must be random to each computer so that the collision doesn't happen again. So as I stated before, CSMA-CD was used on early Ethernet networks, and it isn't as relevant today due to the advancement in network technology. It was only relevant in the older half-duplex networks, where data communicates in both directions, but not at the same time. Today, we use full duplex networks, where data can communicate in both directions at the same time. And there is also CSMA-CA, which stands for Carrier Sense Multiple Access with Collision Avoidance. Now, this is the access method that's used for carrier transmission in wireless networks. Because just like wired networks, wireless networks need to avoid collisions as well. So this is how it works. So when a computer wants to send data on a wireless network, it really can't sense or hear if there are any collisions on the network because there's no cable involved. So instead, it does its best to avoid collisions altogether. So in this method, when a computer wants to send data, it'll first sense if there are any other transmissions happening. And if it detects any other transmissions, it'll wait a short amount of time before checking the channel again. And when it checks the channel again, and if it doesn't sense any transmission, it'll wait a short random amount of time, and then it'll go ahead and send its data. Then, once the destination device receives the data, it will respond to the sending computer with an acknowledgement, informing the sender that it has received the data. But if the sending computer does not receive an acknowledgement from the destination, it will assume that it did not get the data and it will start the process all over again. Now, another method that CSMA-CA uses to avoid collisions is the optional RTS-CTS protocol, which stands for Ready to Send, Clear to Send. Now, this is an optional protocol that's used with CSMA-CA on wireless networks. This protocol enables a computer to send out an RTS or Ready to Send signal to the wireless access point, requesting for an opportunity to send out its data. And if the wireless access point grants this request, the access point will temporarily stop all other communication on the network, and then it'll respond back to the computer with a CTS or clear to send signal, which tells the computer to go ahead and send its data. So in this protocol, the wireless access point is basically the traffic controller on the wireless network.